All right, guys, let's talk about the very first thing that Scythe is doing right. They start with letting you use the included AMD backplate. Now, sometimes when I am doing an install like this, though, I don't mind putting a little piece of tape to hold that on there, but you know, this time I think we'll be all right. So they've got these little black spacers that you're gonna put on there. So they will fit right over the knob just like that. And that might actually just semi-hold there if we're really careful. Then we have the metal bracket. And so it's got slots for both AM4 and AM3 right there. And so once we put the screw through, oh yeah, and then just so you see, there's this same kind of point, this little spot here is kind of outdented, so you want that facing up, so just like that. So I'll put my screw through here, once again, kind of the bottom left hole there in perspective to the upper hole. And if I slide that baby just right in and just start that thread a little bit, then we'll have brackets in, and I just got to get in on both sides. And so as you can see, everything's going to line up perfectly. Also, look at this ridiculously long screwdriver that Scythe included. And so Noctua, they do something similar, but they always include like a handlebar at the bottom. That handlebar kind of sticks out. It's kind of obnoxious to spin. This guy's just a legit handle. I love this. It's the best screwdriver to include the CPU cooler ever. So even though I haven't gotten to the actual tower part, I can easily grab the shaft. And then when I want to crank down, I've got a nice handle to just to do a nice cinch like that. That is awesome. I'm already loving what I'm starting to see. Let's see if we run into any other issues though before we call it a definite winner just yet. Okay, so something that also Riven did with their cooler, but Scythe is doing this, is they've got this crazy offset here so that you have plenty of room for RAM clearance, but you know, the plate itself is still centered with the processor. So, and then unlike though some of the other coolers though, the mounting bracket is secured onto the base there. They've got a single screw. We could actually take this off if we wanted to, but we won't need to. And so there's this, you know, sometimes when you're doing some of these CPU coolers, you're gonna have to flip this case on its back. Make sure that you're gonna be able to reach fine. But once I get this one screw to line up, oops, I almost had it. It would still be easier if I turned my case on its side like that. But once I get the screws to drop into that little hole there, bam. So see, not too hard at all. This is an excellent mounting system. So I'm just gonna wiggle this just a little bit to kind of even out that thermal paste. And then I'm just gonna start cinching it down, taking it a little bit one side at a time, coming back to the other side. I'm going to wiggle it a little bit more again. And now I'm gonna finish cinching it down the rest of the way. Bam. That, my friends, is an install right there. Guys, I gotta say that what Scythe has given me there actually rivals and slightly tops even Noctua. And that's saying a lot, because usually nobody tops Noctua. All right, guys, I'm gonna find it. I know I've got it sitting around here somewhere. I've got a little fan clip doohickey that was specially made for this CPU. Oh yeah, right there. All right, so the other thing that we've got going on with Scythe, and this is something that I already kind of picked at a little bit last time, but look at that. We got a nice clean hook right there so that when we put this into the fan mounting holes, I mean, it's going to hook in there and it's gonna stay. So I'm going to actually put these clips now on both sides, just like so. And now, we should have very little to no trouble getting this fan mounted. So we'll just pull these guys out a little bit. Oops. Accidentally popped off one of those fans. Oh, wow. This fan notches into... Whoa. That's cool. I'm doing this wrong, guys. So last time it was on the inside holes that you had to go to. This guy actually mounts here on the outside holes. So, bam. This fan actually will sit into a notch that's built into this cooler. And once it's set in there, you just have to pull this a little ways to hook on to the edge there. So that is an excellent, excellent design. Guys, wow. I mean, look at that. That is, by Jove, amazing. Huh. By Jove, amazing. That is just great, guys. This is... Get my fan connection in here. I don't know, guys. That is about the best install experience I've ever had. Dang. I don't know. Like, they give that... That...
I'm impressed.